Welcome to this week's edition of Way Back Wednesday. I'm Karen Stone, the Museum Division Manager for St. Mary's County, here today with the story of St. Ignatius Loyola, the least likely man to become the founder of the Jesuits or any other religious order. I'm at the Jesuit Cemetery, founded in 1661 on their original manor at Newtown Neck. Ignatius of Loyola was born in the Basque region of Spain in 1541 and spent his youth preparing to be a soldier and a courtier. As a young adult, he was by all accounts quite a ladies' man. So how did this charming courtesan come to found one of the most influential religious orders in history? Well, on this day, May 20th, 1521, during the Battle of Pamplona, Ignatius's leg was shattered when struck by a cannonball. Fashion at the time for men included tight stockings and breeches that stopped above the knees. Quite the problem for a gentleman with a shattered leg. So he agreed to undergo several surgeries to fix the bones and make his leg presentable again. His recovery was long and painful after a number of subpar surgeries were performed on his broken limb, which left him with a substantial limp. While recuperating at the family castle in Loyola, yes, he had a family castle, Ignatius found reading the many books in the castle's library to be one of the only things he could do as a temporary invalid. And instead of his usual stories of knights and crusades and warfare, what he found were books on the life of Jesus and all the saints. As he read, he began to think, if St. Francis or St. Dominic could do such amazing acts, maybe I could do great things too. So he turned from heroics on the battlefield to serving God. Unsurprisingly, this was very much against the wishes of his noble family. He began his new life with a pilgrimage to the Benedictine Abbey in Montserrat, Spain in 1522 at the age of 31. Before entering, he stripped off his garments and gave them to a beggar, then entered and laid his sword at the feet of a statue of the Virgin Mary. After years of wandering, Ignatius determined that he needed to become a priest, so needed to return to school. In 1528, he went to Paris, where he met fellow future saint Francis Xavier, and with him and four other students made a solemn pact of chastity and poverty in 1534. Ignatius and his companions asked the Pope for formal approval to start a new religious order, the Compañía de Jesús, or the Society of Jesus. They initially had a tough time winning approval. The problem was that at the time, the church believed that members of the religious orders should be cloistered behind monastery walls, not out in the world. But Ignatius stood firm. His men were to be contemplatives in action, leading others to find God in all things, in the world, not of the world. Approval was finally won in 1540, after a vow of obedience was added to the others. Ignatius spent the rest of his life in Rome as the superior of the Jesuits, writing the Jesuit constitutions and sending his brethren to all corners of the globe where they were to seek the greater glory of God and the good of all humanity, to devote themselves to the care of souls, to help people discern God's presence in their lives, to find God in all things. He died on July 31st, 1556 and was canonized March 12th, 1622. He is the patron saint of the Society of Jesus, soldiers, and educators. It was one of these Jesuits, Father Andrew White, who came to the New World in 1634 and helped found the Catholic colony of Maryland. Father Andrew White joined the Jesuits in 1607 while living in Belgium, having been banned from England the year before. White is credited with converting the first Lord Baltimore to Catholicism, and for that reason was invited by Calvert to join his colonization project in America. Sir George Calvert died before the Maryland project got underway, but Cecil Calvert, the second Lord Baltimore, encouraged Father White to join him, and so he did. White himself wrote of the benefits of converting the native population, and in a document dated February 10, 1633, he specifically advocated Catholic settlement in Lord Baltimore's plantation in Maryland. So come to Maryland he did, and between 1634 and 1650, there averaged four permanent Jesuits in the colony, furthering the missionary work begun by Ignatius Loyola nearly 100 years earlier. The rest, of course, is history. Thanks for being here today. I'll see you again next week.